How many of you are familiar with the Venus project? Okay. I'll go through it briefly to give you an idea of what we're working towards. We feel that the way the world is going today is completely downhill, that our language was designed hundreds of years ago, and we really talk at each other than to one another. And so I'm going to tell you a little bit about the proposals of the Venus Project. If I fail to answer your questions, you have to let me know that. Raise your hand and say, you didn't answer my question. Don't be polite. Is there anything you don't understand? Question it. It's up to you now. Okay, now these are the assumptions we make. That you'll have war, poverty, depression continuously until all the nations of the world are brought together and the earth is used as a common heritage of all the world's people. If you don't understand that, if you think that money is the only thing which you're brought up to believe in this culture, if you're stranded on an island with $10 million and there's no water, no fish, no arable land, you have nothing. Money is a nothing thing. It never did represent the physical entities that enable us to live. Politicians, all of them, can do nothing to make the world a better place. They do not understand technology. And they do not understand what to do. All nations are going downhill now. This is the first time in history that there's been wars all over the world, and we've had unemployment. War has always been big business. Get that through your head. It's not to bring democracy to other countries. It's to exploit them, use them, in whatever way we can. I want to try to get that across to you. Let's assume that you are drafted into the army. You put up your life to defend the country. If that's true, then we should draft all the war industries so no one makes a buck out of war, and it's real. If you draft all the industries so they get the same basis of pay as the soldiers that put their lives up to defend this country, it's real. But if people make millions of dollars selling machine guns, submarines, aircraft, it's not real. It's big business. Now, there's a book written called Arms and the Men. Did anyone ever hear of it? Isn't that amazing? A friend of mine was a pilot in World War I. He flew over a German munition dump called I.J. Farben and had orders not to bomb it. He didn't know why. He said he flew over 8 times. With strict orders not to bomb it. After the war, he found out why. DuPont had holdings in I.J. Farben, an American company. Now, of course, another aspect of war. We've been killing Japanese soldiers in the South Pacific Islands in World War II. The truth is, Alexander P.D. Seversky of Seversky Aircraft Company said that what we needed at that time was long-range bombers to knock out the power projects in Germany, the jams, the dams, the electric generators, and shut down the factories. But if you shoot soldiers on every island in trenches, it has nothing to do with bringing war to an end. War has always been big business, loaded with lies and deceptions. Now, how many Americans knew that American soldiers used to cut off Japanese ears and make necklaces of them? One person, amazing. The book is called A New American History. If you really want to know where we're at, we're in the same case as all other nations, corrupt as hell. The Center for the Study of Democratic Institutions in Santa Barbara, their writers said that this is the most corrupt country in the world. Now what does that mean exactly? That means that according to Charles A. Lindbergh, his father advocated that the government print money and make it available to people, not private banks. Private banks are permitted to lend out money more than they have. They can lend out more and collect interest on it. Well, that's utterly corrupt. If you don't understand that, we always had wars, recession, boom, bust. And what they do in our school books, our history books in particular, do not describe our country as it was or as it is. All history books and all the people back in our history books always did the right thing. They never made any mistakes. They never made any errors trying to... Your history book, everybody says the right thing. There's no such people. That's all over the world. Where do you think we got this land from? We took it by force and violence from the Indians. Then we took California, New Mexico. After we stole all the land we needed, they put up the sign, "Thou shalt not steal." What is true of America is true of all the other countries. When they say the sun never sets on England, how do you think England got all those country controls in the old days? They took it. Now, if they lost, because they would have been called thieves, now they're called conquerors, great conquerors. So, I say, well, if you understand what I'm talking about, the money system is the greatest fraud ever put forth on people. Think of this now. Today, America has 300 submarines. Each one, not according to me, according to the War Department, has more destructive power than all the wars in history. One submarine. Now, where can you go with that? What can you accomplish? But there's a place for particular senators and government officials. They built a place under a mountain for them to go to in case of nuclear war. Well, there's 6 months' supply of food, water, all the necessities of life. What do you come out to? You ever think of that? A burnt out, radioactive, wasted area? How stupid can you be? The Pentagon is made of people, army people. And army people are notoriously stupid because they're not very well read. They don't understand this. What you'd have in Washington if we had a sane society, meaning mentally sane, you'd have a Pentagon of sociologists, social scientists, who can bridge the difference between nations. Soldiers are killing machines. They're trained to kill. You look at them and say, well, at least they're fighting for our country. No, they're not. They're fighting for oil, and they're fighting for economic advantage. I'm sorry to say what I'm saying. I don't like what I'm saying. I wish we were decent folks, but we're not. I don't own any munition companies. I have no political ambitions. I think that politicians say things people like to hear. They have nothing to do with the truth. They don't even know what the truth is. There are some people that I meet that call themselves truth seekers. In order to be a truth seeker, you'd have to know everything to know what the truth is. So there's no such thing. Then there are other people that say man is something more than the sum of his parts. I'm sure you've heard that. So is a Kenneth Radislaus. So is a clock more than the sum of its parts. So what? Man creates the filth in the atmosphere. Pollution of the oceans, the land, man. Man operates guided missiles. They don't go by themselves. Man builds warships. It's a human being that ultimately drops a bomb on cities and they pin a medal on them. And they put an X on the fuselage for how many villages you bombed out. And people think, well, that's good. At least I'm defending my country.